हेलो। कैन समवन लेबल द पावर प्रोड्यूसिंग डिवाइसेस? हेलो, कैन यू हियर मी? Yeah, so power producing devices. Yeah, very good. So engine, okay, turbine, generator, nuclear power plant, thermal power plant. So all these are what say power producing devices. Great, good. Okay, so you can write down those labels. So I'm not going to go into deeper into this. Okay, so I did not give my introduction. Are you aware of who I am? Is everyone knows my name? Yeah, so you are aware of about me. Okay, great. So since you are IT student, you are going to have an interaction very frequently with me later on as you get into second, third and final year. Okay, with some additional activities. Okay, so now power absorbing devices. So I just talk about power absorbing devices. So this basically absorb a power and produce some sort of work. Okay, so just name few power absorbing devices which uses a power and does some beneficial work for you. Okay, so most common examples which I will be telling is the pump. Okay, so water pumps are most common examples. Compressor. So compressors are one of the examples which absorbs the power and produces the work. Okay, so these are basically a power absorbing devices. Okay, so laptop we cannot say, processor we can say. Okay, so laptop is a full gadget which includes so many devices, and there are some other devices. Okay, so what these other devices does, basically it allows the transfer of energy, so such as heat exchanger. Okay, then maybe any conversion of energy devices, maybe condenser. Okay, then I'll have evaporator. Okay, so these are the devices which fall under category, which involves only in transfer of energy from one location to another, or maybe even conversion. Okay, so these are called in some categories called as other devices. Okay, now there is a terminology called as thermodynamic system. Okay, so this is my thermodynamic system basically. So it has got a boundary. Okay, and this is system, and this is surrounding. So whatever this outside portion is there, that I called as the surrounding. So there will be always transfer of energy from system to the surrounding through boundaries. So one thing you have to remember, that exchange of energy between system and surrounding takes place through boundary. So there is always a existence of boundary, without which a transfer of energy is not possible. So this is what the importance of boundary is there. Okay, so that's what you have to remember. Okay, now of course there are systems, various types of systems. Okay, so I'll just write types of system now. Okay, so, or you can do classification, whatever it may be. So first type is closed system. Okay. The second is isolated one. And third is open system. Okay. So in closed system, so I draw the figure. So this is system. Okay. Then the flow in or out related to mass is always restricted. It is not present. It is not present. So this is what we call as a closed system. That means there won't be any kind of exchange of mass between system and the surrounding through boundaries. So mass is not exchange, rather than it is not present, means rather than I say it is not exchanged between surrounding and system. So this doesn't happen, so then we say it is a closed system. And in isolated system, well, both is prevented. So mass transfer is also not allowed, and energy transfer is also not allowed. So this is what we say, it's an isolated system. Okay. Then we have an open system. In open system, both mass and energy transfer is allowed. So this is related to type of system. So if you have understood various types of system, just type system in WhatsApp group. Okay. Fine. So now let's try to have an example of each and every system. Okay. So let's have a closed system. Okay. So for a closed system, I'll draw a sketch which will allow you to understand what I'm trying to do. Okay, so let's say this is a container and I have a plunger. Okay, so this is my plunger. Okay, fine. Now, and here in this case, let us say some fluid is present. Okay. So now you can see here in this case, let us say some sort of heating equipment I put it over here. Okay. And it is, let us say, connected to some supply voltage. Okay. And some equipment is there. And now you could see here in this case, so whatever the fluid is present here, you can say a fluid is present. Okay. And what is the boundary? So I'm shading portion. Okay. So this hatch portion is nothing but the boundary of system. Okay. So you will understand what is the boundary. So this hatch portion, whatever I am showing you, is called as boundary. Okay. So this boundary will always exist. Now if you see here in this case, okay, so this fluid is not allowed to go outside. The fluid is not allowed to go outside through boundary. Okay, it is not allowed to go outside through boundary. So it has been prevented. So this is what I say, it is a closed system. But this, whatever the boundary is there, it is a metallic. Okay, since it is metallic, and if I am heating inside, so naturally what I am going to have, I am going to have a heat transfer. Okay, so there will be an exchange of heat from the system to the surrounding. So what is the system? So this what is enclosure. So this is the enclosure, what I am again drawing. So maybe I use some different color pen. Okay, so I select red. So this is my system. Okay. So inside portion is system and then outside is surrounding. So what is taking place? Only heat transfer, but fluid or mass, whatever, that transfer is not there, and therefore such system we called as a closed system. This is how it is going to work. Okay. So let us say you have a pressure cooker at your home. Okay, so I just draw a figure. Okay, so something like this, you have a pressure cooker And let us say it does not have a wall. So generally here wall is present, that we call as a pressure relief wall. So let us say if this wall is absent, so whatever the steam is generated, that will be staying inside and it will not be going out. So such system will also represent a closed system. Okay. So just let me know if you have understood this. If you can type CS, closed system, if you understood, you can type CS. Now, what is a basically an isolated system? So, isolated system, I am trying to draw, there is no perfectly isolated system, okay. So, I am trying to have an isolated system. So, I am taking same example, okay. Again, same, here the fluid is there. Okay, so it is filled. Now these walls are much thicker and basically it stands as an insulation. Okay, so when it's an insulation and if there is a heater inside this, okay. Now what is happening? The inside fluid temperature will rise, but because of this insulation, the energy transfer between the wall and surrounding will be prevented because of this insulation system. And such system I call this as an isolated system. So there is no perfectly isolated system, but we can try to make an isolated system. Okay. So if you have understood isolated system, you can type IS. Great. So I draw a cylinder. Okay, so let's try to correct this. Okay. So let's consider this is a piston. Okay, this is cylinder. So you can consider your bike basically. So from here, air plus fuel, this mixture is coming. Okay. So from where it is coming? It is coming from outside. So this is system. Piston and the cylinder is a system. So it is coming from somewhere else outside, from the surrounding, from your fuel tank, and air is coming from the surrounding. So fuel tank is also your surrounding. It is a part of surrounding. So that is coming inside. And what is happening? When it comes inside, a burning process takes place inside piston and cylinder, and because of that, the expansion process works and we get the work done. And finally, we do have an exhaust, and that exhaust is nothing but we call this as a flue gas. Okay. So this flue gas is the burn combustible product plus some amount of air. Okay, so that will be a flue gas that will be coming out. So what is happening here in this case? The mass. So it is getting inside the system and mass. It is going out of the system. So that means not only energy, because the heat is going to generate it, that is going to dissipate to the surrounding through the wall of the cylinder. But at the same time, there is an exchange of mass between surrounding and the system. And such system, we call this as an open system. Okay. So these are the examples of various types of systems. So if you understood this open system, just let me know. You can type OS. Okay, great. So that's for all. So it's now 4. Okay, so fine. So that's all for what you say classification of the system. Now we have to move towards a thermal equilibrium. Okay, so there are various laws of thermodynamics. Just like you have the laws of motion, we have the laws of thermodynamics. So okay. So first is zeroth law. So zeroth law of thermodynamics. Okay. So what is the meaning? So I'm going to just explain. Okay. Rest of the thing you have to search and find. Okay. So first thing is, let us say there is one metallic ball. So let us consider this is made up of copper, okay, and let us say its temperature is maybe, let us say, 100 degrees Celsius, okay, and there is another metallic ball, and let us say it is made up of iron, and its temperature, let us say, 10 degrees Celsius, okay. Now what I do? I will bring these two balls together. Okay. I'll bring these balls together. So one is at 100 degrees Celsius and other is at 10 degrees Celsius. Okay. So there is something going to happen. So first I will say A option. Energy transfer. The second is mass transfer. And third is no effect. Okay. So what is going to happen? You have to let me know whether it is A, B, C or all options are correct. Okay, so there is no mass transfer, there is only a energy transfer, that is what is going to happen. Mass transfer will not be there. Okay, so energy transfer will take place. Okay, now let us say after say long time, after certain long time, something will happen. Okay, so A option is, A option is both will be heated. So B is temperature of both ball will become equal. Third option. So no effect. Okay. So what's going to happen after a long time? Okay, so temperature of both ball becomes equal. That is what it is going to happen. Okay, so this is what it is based on, law of thermal equilibrium. So this is what we call as a law of thermal equilibrium. Okay, so it is based on thermal equilibrium, and this forms basis of temperature measurement. Okay, so we have a human body, and then we can connect, okay, thermometer to a body of human, and the thermometer will denote the temperature of body, human body. Why? Because human body and thermometer will be in thermal equilibrium after some time. Okay, so that sometimes generally is around 2 minutes. So if you want to measure a temperature of human body, what will we put the thermometer and we wait for, we wait for 2 minutes, because initially those two body will be at different temperature, they will not be at the same temperature. Okay, some time is to be allowed so that they will attain a thermal equilibrium, and whatever the temperature represented by the thermometer, because thermometer will now be at the temperature of human body. So whatever temperature denoted by thermometer is nothing but the temperature of the human body. That is how the working principle behind the thermometer. So if you have understood the working principle of thermometer, you can take TH. Okay. Law of conservation of energy. Okay, so law of conservation of energy. So what it suggests? Energy neither can be created not could be destroyed okay so it can have a, it can change the form it can change the form okay so this is what basically the laws of conservation of energy say that energy can neither be created nor could be destroyed it can be only converted from one form to another so this is what the law of conservation of energy suggests okay so on the basis of this there are many types of energies which we are talking about thermal energy electrical energy wind energy solar energy okay so there are lots of forms of energy and this conversion happens okay or mechanical energy you can say so motor what motor does it converts electrical energy into a mechanical energy so that is a function of motor so only what you can do you can convert the energy from one form to another that form the basis of various power producing as well as power absorbing devices because what power producing means it converts from one form of energy to the other just a moment Yeah, so just let me know whether I am audible or not. Okay fine so next is the first law of thermodynamics okay so it is based on Joule's experiment okay fine so it just going to require much more amount of time for completion of Joule's experiment once that is done so we will enter into a first law and then the applications like refrigeration systems and all those stuff will start okay so today we are going to stop it here hope you liked the today's lecture you can leave the feedback in WhatsApp group how do you feel about the lecture okay so I feel FCC is comfortable now many of you was telling the lot of problems with FCC but I don't think so there is a issue in my lecture as far as FCC I am using it okay so you can just let me know in WhatsApp group whether feedback about the lecture if any changes is required from my side just let me know okay so thank you for attending the lecture so you can start leaving thank you